need that over here in front of the backdrop so we can take a few pictures. Of the main mail, I have a certain dog of a single child who is always asking that people come in. Hit it front and center in the first round of pictures. And then we'll get you to look to the left and right in just a little bit. 那么当然黑人从这个出生当到澳洲版一直走到他最后被这个封为有所谓 Curtis Stone 接班人的这个统啊，再接下来还有几个人，我跟现在变成一个选手，布洛克啊，今天终于能够邀请到他来到台湾秀了，莫大的荣幸啊。那如果说各位有现在非常热衷于这个主持烹饪的，也可以跟他稍微学习一下。All right, a little to the left, please, for the cameraman. Anything you want, anything you want. There you go, now that's the classic Adrian pose.
走，我们把这个下面把掌声拿回来吧。OK，
讲到冲浪，其实他跟我讲说他这次来台湾没有机会，他虽然骑过花莲，骑过宜兰，但是没有机会去冲浪，所以说下次应该会再回来台湾，继续这个探索一下台湾各地的这个美术。那I
understand that Nick actually had a chance to go surfing a little bit, right?
Tomorrow.
所以说Nick其实来到台湾，除了工作以外，他同时自己也希望亲身体验一下、发掘一下台湾冲浪的一些这个美景啊。所以说
you're gonna stay for a couple of days, but then 待一两天。
Exactly, Taiwan is really beautiful. Alright, we can get you off the bike now. Alright, let's have a conversation with Hayden.
But last time you didn't really get a chance to ride a bicycle nor go around Taiwan, so are there anything that's very impressionable for your trip this time?
I think, yeah, last time I was here, I spent a couple of days in Taipei, but this time it was a completely different experience. We got to travel, obviously, the whole way around the island, and I guess see the real Taiwan. You know, see Taiwan as it truly is, the beautiful people, the amazing nature, and of course the incredible cycling roads. The paths are just, it's like riding on this, it's perfect. Nick will probably back me up. In Australia, we have the worst roads in the world. When you come to Taiwan, it's like riding on a cloud. It's amazing. So we had such an incredible experience.
他说上一次来台湾都是待在台北啦，不过台湾真的有很多可以发掘的地方。那他也大大称赞台湾的这个单车自行车道，甚至非常平坦哦。他说在澳洲的 Outback or you know the back roads，他们的路骑起来非常的颠簸，来到台湾真的就像骑在云端一样哦。那接下来呢，我们就稍微聊一下他这个对于美食或者是一些这个厨师厨艺方面的问题。So
you recently had a post on your Instagram about cooking a whole entire Christmas meal for a family. Was that a lot of pressure, first off?
Huge pressure. Christmas in Australia is like, because it's obviously summer.
Right.
You know, it's a beach time, it's a relaxing time, but the person that cooks seems to have the most pressure put on them because everyone's hungry, everyone's having a couple of beers, so it's a tough time.
I have a question for myself. Is it true that Santa Claus wears board shorts in Australia?
Just speedos.
因为大家都知道，南半球嘛，跟我们刚好其实是相反的，所以说在北半球过圣诞节的时候，他们刚好是炎热的夏天，所以他们的圣诞老人当然就不能穿着红袍，而是穿这个红袍那个油桶的短裤啊，为大家送礼物。然后他最近也为一家人做了这个圣诞晚餐，所以我刚刚稍微问一下，说会不会有很多的压力？Now,
what about the recently passed Lunar New Year? This is also a festive based, a very feast based kind of festivity. Do you think you're ready to challenge some Chinese cuisine now that you visited some parts of Asia?
Am I ready to take on the Taiwanese cuisine? With a lot of practice. I think it's amazing how varied the food is here. You know, even for such a small nation, that you go from one township to the next and there's a speciality here, a speciality there, so I don't think I'm ready, no.
No, really?
I'm not ready.
好，他说虽然已经为了他的家人做了一整桌的这个圣诞晚餐，但是大家觉得他可能还是无法挑战台湾料理。他说真的太难了。